नमः शिवाय। इन दिस क्लास ऑफ क्लास 11 ज्योग्राफी आई शैल डिस्कस अबाउट सम हिमालयन रिवर सिस्टम देयर ओरिजिन सोर्स देयर फ्लोइंग पाथ्स फ्रॉम द चैप्टर 3 ड्रेनेज फ्रॉम पार्ट बी फिजियोग्राफी ऑफ इंडिया। सो फर्स्ट रिवर व्हिच आई शैल डिस्कस टुडे इज द इंदास ड्रेनेज सिस्टम। इन द हिमालयन रिवर there are three important drainage system, Indus, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra. So first one I shall discuss, this is the Indus drainage system. This system comprises of the Indus river and the five main tributaries, the Jhelum, the Chenab, the Ravi and the Bees and the Satluj. The Indus originate from a glacier near the Vokar Chu, 31 degree 15 minute north latitudes and 81 degree 40 minute east longitudes in Tibetan region at an altitude of 4164 meter in the Kailash mountain range. So the where from the Indus mountain originate, it is known as the Singhi Khamban or the lion's mouth. I'm repeating once, the originating place of Indus river is known as Singhi Khamban and it is originated from the glacier Vokar Chu, 31 degree 15 minute north latitude to 81 degree 40 minute east longitude in the Tibetan portion. Now, it flows west and northwestward and enters Indian territory in the Jammu Kashmir. See this picture. This is the Jammu and Kashmir. So, this is the boundary where this river enters into the India. This river forming a spectacular gorge in this reach and the Kailash range several times. It flows through the Ladakh and the Gilgit. The Indus receives a large number of Himalayan tributaries, both of its right and the left bank. The main tributaries are the Shayak, Gilgit, Jaskar, Hunza, Shigar, etc. are the important tributaries. One of these you can see is the Gilgit, is the important tributary. And it finally emerges out of the hills at Attock, where it receives the Kabul River on its right bank. This is the Kabul River. So Kabul River is in the right bank and there are other also, Shayak, Gilgit, etc. So I'm repeating once, where from the Indus River originate? It is actually originate from the Vokar Chu Glacier, which is also known as the Singhi Khamban or the lion's mouth. After that it passes through and in the Jammu Kashmir boundary it enters into the India. Its right bank tributaries are the Shayak, Gilgit, Jaskar, and it finally emerges out of the hills at Attock, where it receives the Kabul River in its right bank. The other important tributaries joining the right bank are the Khuram, Tochi, Gomal, Viva, Sangar. All these tributaries originate in the Sulaiman range and this river flows southward and receives Punjab a little above Mithankot. Punjab is the name given to the river of the Punjab, namely the Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bees and the Satluj. It is finally discharged into the Arabian Sea east of the Karachi. The Indus flow in India through Jammu Kashmir only. With a total length of 2,880 kilometers, the Indus is considered as one of the largest river of the world. So, if you consider this map again, you will see that, see the arrow, actually this is the Indus, this is the main stream of the Indus. So Indus is flowing the southward, this is the southward flowing. So this part is the right bank tributaries, all the right banks, Gilgit, Sowat, Kabul, or the right bank tributaries. And the left bank, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Satluj, Bees. And this is actually in the Mithan Court in the Punjab. It enters into the India. And why it is known as the Punjab? Because five rivers, Indus, Jhelum, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bees and the Satluj. These five rivers actually flowing this region. That's why this is known as the Punjab. And the total length is 2880 kilometers, and that's why it is known as the one of the largest, longest river. So the first left bank tributary is the Jhelum. The Jhelum, it rises a spring at Velinag, situated in the southeastern part of the vale of the Kashmir. It flows northwards from its source to Ular Lake and further down to southwestward until it enters a gorge cut by this river in the Pir Panjal range. It turns to the northwest below Uri and the south below the Muzaffarabad and the continues until Mangla it's reached. Between the Muzaffarabad and the Mangla, it turns roughly along the Indo-Pakistan border. It's joined Chenab and Jhang in Pakistan. So if you go the previous map again, you'll see that this river is the Jhelum River and it rises from the vale of Kashmir. So here is the Kashmir valley of the vale of the Kashmir. So here from the Jhelum is originated and it flows the northward from its source and to the Ular Lake and further down to the south. Okay. And again it meets the Chenab River. Now the Chenab River is the Chenab of the Jammu and the Kashmir state is known as the Chandrabhaga in the Himachal Pradesh, because it's formed of the two streams, the Chandra and the Vaga, which join at the Kilang. Chandravaga flows northwestern or westwards and runs parallel to the Pir Panjal range for some distances. Near Kishtwar, it cuts a deep gorges in the Pir Panjal range and turns southwards and flows in this direction. There are other tributaries also, the Ravi, the Vyas and the Satluj. I shall discuss about these three tributaries in my next class. For this class, this is all. Namah Shivaya.